Welcome to a new test and teardown video. Look at this multimeter. It's a Sinclair Multimeter DM2. And what do you know? This is in mint condition. Oh, if I look real careful, I can maybe find a tiny little scratch. But it is really, really beautiful. Ooh, yeah, be careful not to drop it. I guess this one is from the late 80s or something about that. It says warning use only Sinclair mains adapter, and they forgot to write voltage plus minus and whatnot here. So I am forced to open it and see if I can figure out what is plus and minus and how many volts. So that will be the first thing we do, is find the screwdriver. Okay, the back plate here is removed, and what do you know? I think this is the first time I see such a nice and smart way to do it. So they marked everything here. RV, this and that, and so that will be all the trimmers. And look at that. It's supposed to dry cell or rechargeable. I could have used a little list of the trimmers, what they do. That is the only thing they didn't explain here on this sheet. Isn't it funny? It's not straight. They could have spent 10 seconds more to put it straight. This is what happens. It's made in Germany. No, it's made in England. So that is why, you see? You would never see this in German product, no? Look at that. It is just, that is real smart with this PCB, and then there's those pins through the other board. That is nice and easy. So that is the input. So this can do voltage. It can't do amps. AC volts, AC milliamps. Yeah, it can only do milliamps. And that is why you see those thin wires going to those switches like this. And then we have a fuse of, is that 2.5 amp? Really? 60 milliamp fuse. And it almost fit the socket. What is that component? Is that an inductor or some special? I don't know. Maybe this is an oscillator. So what I need to find out is about, I'm a little bit worried about the red and the brown wires. They're mounted like this, and then the red wire go here. So this is the red and the black for the battery, and it says red is positive. See? Positive, positive. Thank you. That is good. So now I need to measure. Red here is not the center pin. So it was really, really a good idea that I opened it and not just plugged in something. I believe we are ready now to crank up the voltage. What I did was I measured the center pin of the connector to be the red wire, and the red wire is directly connected to the battery red. I measured 50 ohms between the black battery and the ground wire. So that is probably the charge current system, because you can put in a rechargeable battery, but I have no idea about how many volts. So here's what I will do. I will just power this on, and I will crank up the voltage real slow and see if there is any current. I believe it's going to start. What, that is 6. Oh, we see something now. Look at that. So that was 7 volts. Oi, it is. Oh, I'll have to turn this light off. So now that was 7. See, 7 volts. And now I go down again and see when will. Oh, so it's fading. 5, 6, 7. So that means I will give this 9. There's probably a 9 volt regulator. Yeah, great. So that is, I am in volts DC. Aha, 1 volt for full re... Oh, that is 3, 4, that is 1 millivolt. And there is a pot meter here for a zero set. I will, of course, have to switch. Oh, yeah, we have to put this upside down. Hang on a second. In the lowest range, 1 volt full range, I had to shorten the input to make it zero. And what I did is I slowly raised the voltage and monitored the current consumption. And it's just almost no raise in current. So there is, of course, a voltage regulator in here that will run in anything here at 5 volts or something like that, I guess. So yeah, I can now power this with 12 volts DC, and then we can carry on with the test of this unit. So now we're ready for with the test of this unit. Meanwhile, we had done a little bit of Googling around, and it seems to be from 1975. And the battery and the charger is supposed to be 9 volts. So maybe we should change this the power supply to 9 volts. But anyway, this one runs also pretty good at 12 volts. So now I'm feeding in 12 volts and I am double checking. It's about 12 volts. And it also reads about 12 volts. So I really think this nice unit works. We should also try and see what happens if I go to the 1000 volt range. And then of course 1 volt is now the last digit, so it will all, there will always be at least plus minus one digit, right? And then we got 10. Hey, how about we go a little bit down under 10? So 9.9. okay, so it's 9.8. okay, and then we go to the next range. Okay, I think it is probably within specifications. You never know. We could probably Google the specifications and kilo ohm and AC and milliamps as well. So this is a 1K resistor and we are in 1K range. This, okay, I will first try and short circuit. See? So this is zero. Okay. One, this would be 1 ohm, right? And then I try to measure the 1K. Look at that. So this meter from 1975 really, really works. I am impressed. Oh, we managed to find a bug in this unit. Everything here is now connected correctly. 2 meters in series. This is 100 milliamps. This one also says 100 milliamps, and the current goes through this meter. I am in, it's not easy to see, milliamp, 1000 milliamp. Whoops, look at that. This is not right. And if I go to 100 milliamp, so this should be full range. Look at that. So something is completely wrong in the current ranges. Probably something about trimming. But we need to investigate this a little bit deeper. Let's look a little bit on the schematic for this Sinclair multimeter. And I think this is the input fuse. So this is this will be the 1 amp fuse for the amp. And then it goes down here to the different settings. And so this is, see, 1000 milliamps, and then the current goes through this resistor, and then this is ohm, or this is non-ohm down to ground, all right? So, look at that. Two tiny little Sina diodes, 3.3 volts each, and they are back to back, so it's plus minus, what, 4 volts, more or less. The idea is that if you have more than 4 volts over a 1 ohm resistor, that is more than 4 amps, right? So the idea is those two little tiny diodes should break the fuse and save everything else. And by the way, this fuse was a 2.5 amp fuse in this unit. So of course we need to replace this fuse with a 1 amp fuse, and probably also replace the sinners with some more powerful sinner diodes, so that will work. Other than that, the schematic is a little bit confusing. It is made a little bit upside down, and but this is just the way it was done back in the good old days. This is the internal battery with a charge diode, and it's basically what it is. And this is of course the readout system. And yeah, we were able to find this resistor for the current calibration, so we could make it read out really, really nice and accurate. So that was a big, big success.
I am the guy that just never gives up. See, this is the milliamps on the meter and on the fluke. This one we know is right. So, and it was those two protection diodes, they were completely shorted. So somebody gave it peak currents that raised the voltage over the sense resistors and then shorted the current ranges. What I did here, I know, I'm so sorry, I am a really bad boy, but so far I just cut open the diode like this just to prove my point. And now we can of course replace the diodes when we want to, but now the error is found and now the meter works.